my background is in political science, and I have an assessment of disease, democratization and corruption. And as part of my dissertation, I did a lot of anti-corruption policy evaluations. And in 2008, I started attending the American Evaluation Association Conference and presenting these policy evaluations. About 3 years ago, though, I started doing program evaluation. And as part of that, I started to use logic models. Now, the approach I've been using is called semi-structured interview protocol approach, and it has been developed by my husband, Ristei Gugiu, who is a faculty here in the CREM, in collaboration with Eliana Rodriguez Campos, who is a faculty at the University of South Florida. This particular approach actually has been used in the United States by various agencies, two biggest ones are USDA and NIH. It has also been used in Australia, Europe, and South Korea, discovered recently, but I was just looking to see who has been using this particular approach. And it also has a lot of flexibility in the sense that it can be used in different fields. And I found it being used in business and economics, in healthcare, and education, and criminal justice. So it is quite versatile. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to just present the steps that I'm going into applying this particular approach in the logic model, and I'm going to show you an example of a logic model that we just recently, it's a draft that we recently created for a program that we are evaluating more. So the first thing in applying this particular approach is to identify the key informants, the key stakeholders in the program. We want to be able to talk to and interview the people that have information about the program, and they can tell you, you know, how the program works, if they have a vision of the program. And you want to be able to talk to people that are at different stages, so to speak, on the scale of the program, from the higher ups to the ones that are implementing the program in the field, because they will give you different type of information. They will have different visions, and you want to get a much more comprehensive image of the program. Second step would be to, this interview protocol allows you to basically get background and contextual information about the program. What does it mean? What was the reason for which this program was created in the first place? And are there any social, cultural, political factors that play into how the program functions and factors that may impact the way the evaluation will be going on? The generating the logical model elements is, I think, the easier part, because here everyone has talked about the inputs, the activities and outputs, and the outcomes, and the varying and structure depending on the type of the program, the scope of the program, into short-term, intermediate, or long-term outcomes. Modeling program outcomes refers to identifying whether these outcomes are at the individual level, at the organizational level, they have, if the program is a larger program that has a goal to change community outcomes, and you'll have a community level outcomes. More than maybe even larger than that, depending on the scope of the program. Once you identify these outcomes, of course, we can look at the activities and the outputs that go into the outcomes. And here again, you can model them based on the same way. You know, individual activities, you know, that are your activities that will target individuals or families, or activities that will take place at the organizational level or at community level, again, based on the scope of the program. Modeling program inputs refers to not only identifying the resources that are going into this program, but also whether there are resource gaps. Because this will give you information about how well the program functions based on the resources they have, and will give you some idea about what may be going on given the they have this outcome, they have these activities, but maybe they don't have enough resources, and that's why they are not effective in what they are doing, and they are not reaching the outcomes that they want to reach. Building a rational theory is another effort that's going on through this process, where we are always asking the interviewees, are these outcomes realistic? Are they meaningful? Are they specific enough? We want to make sure that they are measurable. Can you measure, you give me this outcome, is this outcome measurable? How would you measure it, you know, if you were to look at this particular outcome? So we want to make sure that they actually are realistic and they don't come with the example I'm going to give you is a ready for kindergarten program. And if their outcome is to for all the children to go to college, well, that is not really a realistic outcome for them. So I want to make sure that they have an understanding of that. Developing a program theory is the next step where you basically they're with them at the end when they give us all the information about these are the inputs, these are the activities, and the outputs, and these are the outcomes. We say, okay, so now we will connect the resources with the activities and the activities with the outcomes to see how this is going and what's the logical process in here. The important aspect of this logic model is to, particularly for a program evaluation, is to identify what are the most important outcomes for this particular program. And one of the questions that we always ask is, please identify the critically important outcomes of the program. And what that means is that you identify those outcomes that if the program does not do well on these particular outcomes, that would be reflected in the evaluated model. Basically, if you fail on this, reaching these outcomes, you fail on your program. So we have to pause and really think carefully about what they want to really achieve. And that gives them an opportunity to reassess, do we have enough activities that are going towards this particular outcome that we really want to achieve? Do we have enough resources? And should we focus more or less on this outcome? And finally, we build a graphical or technological logic model. So this is a larger model that we created. This is a draft of the ready for kindergarten program. You can see, look, the basic skeleton is the same. We have the inputs, the activities, the short-term outcomes, intermediate, and long-term outcomes, but they are structured a little bit differently. You have here all these things, like steps, and so on. You have the activities. Instead of using arrows, we decided to, and this is a personal preference, of course, because it tends to get messy. Point arrows from every single input to all activities and from activities to outcomes. We decided to use is that, you know, these small parts of the figure to actually indicate which inputs are connected to which activities and which activities are connected with each outcome. These outcomes that are in red, you see here there is a legend which basically said those are critically important outcomes. The ones with blue are identified as moderately important, and the ones that are with the interrupt line are the low important outcomes. So even if they don't reach those particular goals, the program is still successful because they, as long as they reach, of course, they achieve their main outcomes. Now, looking, just to show you one example, I chose the read more which have a regular basis outcome. And this is how it will be. You'll have basically five different that would go with three, are related to three different activities and with one major outcome. And if I would go to back to put arrows, this would get very messy. So this is just personal preference to make it easier to read. And the other thing, if you notice, when talking with them, they kept identifying we would want parents to be able to do these things, right? This would be our outcome for the parent, and we want the child to develop So what we did, we identified the individual outcome based on the parent and the child. What I also did is to look at how many of the interviewees actually endorsed each outcome. And you can see the critically important outcome for the parent, for the child on a regular basis, and for the child, which was developing specific skill and recognized letter sounds, rhyming, or the pen, with control, you know, count. Those were endorsed by every single person that we interviewed. Others, though, as you can see, had a lower endorsement. And this is particularly what's interesting to see when we talk about the intermediate outcomes and long-term outcomes, because sometimes only one person actually endorsed that particular outcome. And when I looked at who actually endorsed that outcome, this was the manager or the director of the program. Now, this was a view what is, I think, what is really good about this particular approach is that it gives you an opportunity to talk to people on different levels. So what we did yesterday afternoon, I had a meeting with the CEO and the CXO organization, and we went with this draft and said, did we capture, you know, the vision of the program as you wanted, right, as you think that the program should be. And they looked at this logic model and they said, no, this is not what we envisioned for the program. This is not our vision. And I said, well, this is the vision that came out from the interviews with 9 of your staff members, including the manager and the director of the program. And basically said, I don't care if the parents remark on the child. All I care is whether the children score higher on the kindergarten assessment, which is because it's a very business-like approach. They say the funders do not care whether the parents have an increased awareness of their role as educators, whether the parents feel empowered as teachers. Or the funders will ask me, did the cross course improve? And that indicates something, that there is somewhere in the communication between the higher ups in the organization and those who are actually working on implementing the program, there was a disconnect. There was somewhere the message that the CEO and the CXO wanted to deliver was distorted. And they said, this is very good. This is, we will stop here and then we'll go and meet with our people and then we'll decide what the vision of the program is that everyone is agreed upon and then we move forward with the evaluation. Why I think this is very important is because think about the alternative. We were hired to do this program evaluation. If we were not, we would have relied only on what the staff told us, the ones that are actually implementing and working on redesigning the program right now. And we have done the evaluation, and a year from now, we will have come up with a report and sent it to the CEO, and the CEO will have been clear and said, okay, parents read more with their children. Parents feel more educated about their role as a teacher. Children know more words, or they can recognize rhyming or hear rhyming. Did they score higher on the call? And if that was not in the evaluation program, then we basically would have failed in our job because they hired us to implement certain vision. And now, so early on in the process, they have an opportunity to go back to reassess what the vision of the program is and to have time to get everyone on the same page. And then we move forward. So I think that's one of the really good things about this particular approach. Besides that, and this is the citation, the article includes a whole battery of questions that can guide you in, and you can use to adapt for your own program evaluation, for your own logic model signal. And I think that is really useful when, especially if you're starting for the first time to do logic model.
Questions. And I will make sure that we send out this citation too.
Is there software for that?
That's a Visio. Yeah, that is a software. It's called Visio. And it's, I think it's a very neat software. It takes you a little bit to get used to it, but once you get used to it, it's actually very easy to go through it. So,
If people contact me, I can give you a copy of the article and even give you the Visio template, which will save you a day of work.